Howdy guys, welcome back to another video of Westland Survival. How are we doing? Hope you guys are well. So today what I want to do is we're going to continue on with the Guardians of Nature quest line here. So we're going to go ahead and deal with the poachers where we sort of left off from the previous video. So we're going to get stuck into that today and see what else needs to be done thereafter. Now I'm not too sure exactly what else needs to be done. So yeah, it'll be interesting to see what else that we need to do with this quest line. So let's have a quick look, see how this is cooking along. Now this is very strange, so I'm not too sure why this has done this, but I'll go ahead and explain. Now the bait itself, it basically only started at midnight my time before the timer basically effectively started elapsing. So even though that I actually had in the previous video proactively finished it by using the coins to get the said bait, it actually hadn't started the timer for this one here up until midnight my time, which I find very strange. I don't know why that is, to be perfectly honest with you. Don't know exactly what the situation is with that, whether it's a bug or whether that is by design to, I guess, stunt the progression with the bait side of things. And I can only sort of theorize that only because, you know, all the mechanics for the pets system hasn't been fully implemented yet. So I'm guessing that's got something to do with it potentially. That's probably what I'm thinking, but I'll digress for now. I thought I just wanted to bring that up while I was sort of on the subject, so at least that way you guys are aware of that too, because I mean, you know, it might happen to you. I don't know if it's just a me thing, couldn't honestly tell you that, but like I said, I wanted to bring that up to you before we did anything. I should have brought some heals with me actually, which yeah, we'll see how we go. Hopefully this is not too crazy, but I should have had some heals along with the ride, and actually should have brought my my links with me. So we're going to be doing that. So I am completely underprepared for this video. Anyway, I'm going to apologize in advance now as well. I don't know if you've already heard it, but as soon as I started recording, a lawnmower started up with one of my neighbors deciding to cut their lawn today. So I apologize if you guys can hear that throughout this video. Hopefully not, but yeah, look, it is what it is. So let me quickly grab some of this. Okay, so we're just gonna grab, you know what, that's probably gonna be sufficient for this. So that's all well and good. I'm gonna quickly heal up with some food and that, and I think we should be okay actually. Yes, we are good. Now, I've only got one cracker, so I'm going to just take that with me anyway. Okay, and we'll take a young guest with us because she has not been fully maxed out with her level. So we're going to try and maybe gain some levels along the way. What do we got there? We've got the shootout spot. Okay, so shootout spot is there. That's all well and good. So we're going to head over and hopefully see how we go here. Now, I haven't taken anything too powerful or anything like that. I don't think I need anything that powerful here, only because I've seen what I've seen, especially from going by the previous video with some of the poachers here. It didn't appear to be too hectic, so let's see how we go. If anything, I've got something in my inventory that I can quickly switch out and we'll get the job done with that. But let's see everything here. Let's do a quickly sneakeroo. Yeah, 270, these guys are nothing. You know what? So I'll let guess take out a couple of these fellas for me. There we go. Hopefully you can get some some levels. So can we? Oh, okay, so we can actually go ahead and release some of these animals here, so which is good. Okay, so you have been released into the wild. Run free, run free. You can see there's a lot of tanning stations here. I'm gonna leave that there. Excuse me, as you can see, look at that. There's a lot of tanning stuff here. Not good, not good. Okay, nothing else going on here. So let's continue on. Okay, so we've got a burglar. I'll let Guest take the reins here. No. Come on. Ah, you got the bleed effect. Ah, there you go. Guest doing that work for me. Like I said, hopefully we'll get some pretty decent levels for her. But as you can see, I've got to deal with 10 of these guys, so we're at 3 at the minute. So I'll take some of that and that. I'll leave that behind. Okay, come here, Mr. Poacher. There we go. There we go, and I'll let you deal with him as well. Very good. Look at that. Pop that there. Take that. And let's release this. Oh, no. There we go. Let's release this deer. There you go. We're halfway there already as well, which is amazing. Okay, so we've got the destroyer here. So let's go ahead and get a pop on him. And I'll just do that. And I think that should be enough for Guess to take this fella out. There we go. Look at that. Good job, Guess. Good job, good job. Okay, okay, so this is a coyote by the looks of things. Yes, it is. Cool, cool, cool. So we're at what? 6 out of 10? We're nearly there. So this doesn't look like it's a crazy zone or anything like that. It's going to take us ages. It's honestly looking like less than 10 minutes. And you'd be able to sort this one out quite easily. Okay, so I'm going to let Guest do the work for me. There we go. And pet level up, as you can see in the top right hand corner. Beautiful. So we got some levels, which is great. Okay, and we got the big boss man here. Okay, so we're at 9 out of 10 here. So I don't know how hectic the boss is going to be. Now, for Guess, she had some injuries here, so I thought I'd just quickly heal you up. Okay, I'll skin this animal for the coin, and you too. Wow, you are terrible, my dude. Terrible. But as you can see, I'm using cult weapons. They're not even that, they're not that powerful, to be perfectly honest with you. Okay, so, oh geez. Hopefully my pet's okay. My pet's immune to that sort of stuff, which is good. Okay, come on. You are down. There we go, Guess got some good. Ooh, what do we get there? An iron tomahawk. Okay, look, I'm definitely not going to take that. I'll end up taking the basalt over that. But just to give you guys a bit of an idea, I did use a tier 4 weapon, but damage was 295, so it was nothing. You can easily get by with tier 3, okay? Or anything that's high powered that I just sort of had in that sort of regard. But, okay, so we've got Henry there. I just want to quickly explore elsewhere just before we release him, just so you guys can see if there's anything else that we can... we can take. I thought there was a little shortcut here, but there's not. But okay. And I'm presuming at the end here we've got just the exit. Yes, we do. Okay, so it's just the exit there. Nothing else that's happening here. Let's go ahead and release Henry the Stumble and see what he's got to say to us. Okay, so thanks for the help. I've been caged for so long, the boss refused to set me free. Or because I didn't find Charles, luckily the dogs were kind. I thought they'd maul me. I begged the boss to open the cage, but he didn't care. And now he's dead, and the others too. What should I do now? I have no home, nowhere to keep my dogs. Can we go with you? I'll talk to Dr. Rayleigh, just show the way to the camp. Okay, so it looks like we're going to take him back. So let's open up this, see what we get. Oh, look, we got some okay stuff. Take those on our adventures. Okay, so you're going to come with us, buddy? And he's got his doggies as well, which is kind of cool. So we're just going to basically head back to the naturalist camp. As you can see, we'll do that right now. So we'll use the last bit of our energy and run up. And as you can see, the poacher's hideout has completely disappeared. So only a just for the fact of the storyline itself, so it doesn't look like it's going to be a permanent thing. Okie dokie. So let us ask Joy and Henry and let's see what they say. Alright, guys. Okay, you're back, so the animals are free. What a relief. And who's that? Well, I know you. You're Henry the Stumble, a poacher we met in the nature park. I came with peace and with dogs. I'll explain everything, just hear me out. Please wait by the cabins. The young man will figure out what to do with you. The boy deserves a second chance. We make many mistakes during our youth. But I digress, my darling and I are so grateful. We'd love to initiate you as naturalists. Okay. Except for one nuance, you must build your own naturalist desk. Okay, so we can actually build it at our camp. Great, okay. Because I was wondering how this was going to happen, whether this camp was going to be permanent. In saying this, it doesn't look like it's going to be. So we've got the pet tins. Awesome. So I guess that's everything. Okay, origin of species, build a naturalist desk, pass initiation. The Raelys want to initiate me into a naturalist. I have to build a naturalist desk first, just like the one Vernon uses. I'll hope I manage. So yeah, it's telling me to head off. Now, I don't know if the place is going to disappear now. I'd imagine it would be. I'd imagine this would be the case. It's still there. So I don't know whether or not we can refer back to it, or depending on the part of this this update and future updates, because there are going to be some more updates with the pets as well. So that not all mechanics are available. So I'd imagine there's going to be some roles that they're going to be playing. It's going to tell us to open up the build menu, furniture. There it is. Okay, I'm going to need to make some more whatchamacallits. I need some nails, so I think we needed two more. So let's go ahead and finish that up. Boom, boom. And we're going to need, and it requires a pine floor. I do want to sort of keep it close. So, okay, so I can sort of build it there for now, but I'll tell you what. Excuse me. I'm going to just put it there for now, just for the purpose of the video, because I'm not going to muck around with, trying to sort out, you know, what I need to do with this. So I'm just going to stick it here, just so we know it's there. We're going to head over to it. So have a quick squiz. So it's basically the same layout as you had with the naturalist camp itself, okay? So yeah, that's basically where that is at. And I know a lot of people are asking, are you going to be able to, tame wolves if you went into the lynx family first? And the answer I'll probably say would be yes, because I'd imagine once this is all done, which we're probably going to find out because it looks like we're tying this up today, that you'd have the flexibility to, go after wolves and things like that. So I'm sure there's something along those lines that we can actually tap into. Actually, while we're here, that little experience with Gessie, I want to see what type of level we're on. Up to level 40, so we gained 3 levels. So that's good. That's good. So we're not quite maxed out yet, which is fine. Damage, 39, which is a good increase as well. I mean, especially when you compare it to, say, Raz, for example, 16, more than double. Okay, more than double. So yeah, tier 2 does look to be pretty tangible to use, I guess, especially if you're if you're trying to max out your pets, or if you're trying to get to tier 3 and it's going to take a while. I think tier 1, and I mentioned this in the previous video, in terms of submitting pets to increase your the ability for you to unlock more bait and stuff like that, the research, sorry. I think that's probably going to be the way to do it. And I say that as well, so I'm hoping that this place will still stick around. Maybe. That's what I'm hoping. Okay, before we speak to Dr. Joy, let's look at the pet. Okay. Wolf. Oh, okay. So it gives you... Oh, wow. So that's Australian currency if you wanted to unlock that. And that's a straight up tier 3. So damage is 20, 122 max damage, health, 400, and max health is 3,092. Gender is random. Ignores attack on defense. Rough. And then again, you get this fella here, and then you've got that. So very, very similar. It's a husky. Huskies are, I love huskies. I really do. If I had a big enough backyard, I'd definitely have a husky. Okay, welcome back. Your eyes don't deceive you. We decided to give Harry a chance. Have you built the natural stairs yet? Also, let's begin your initiation. Okay, initiation started. Okay, by the power of science, we, Joy Vernon-Rayleigh, initiate you as a naturalist. May your experiments be successful, theories. Okay, don't fall out. Fall over the first huddle. Okay, sorry. I won't talk as much, but yeah, I'm sure you guys can stop and pause it and read it if you need to, if you missed some of that like I did. That's okay. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so we're done here. So Henry becomes the merchant. Okay. And you can actually purchase bowls as well. Well, there you go. So you don't necessarily need the old road completely at all times. If you really want to drop coins, or if you've got the coins, let's say, you can utilize that and pay your way through via silver in order for you to get your pet houses up and running as well. And then, as you can see, you've got Wolf Bay, you've got Alpha Wolf Bay, if you want to go down that road as well. So this would be based on coinage if you really wanted to tap into other lineages and lines. So that looks like that's going to happen, I guess. That's probably the way that you're going to be able to get different pets there. Whether or not it changes, but let's go ahead and complete this anyway. We've passed the initiation. And Origin of Species completed. Okay, so we're done. That looks like that's it then. So, yeah, right, okay. I'm interested now that we've finished off everything. If I go back to the bait workstation, does all the tier 1 baits at the very least... Now, what's that primary school? Improved provoking, okay. Excuse me. Does all the baits become available? It does. There you go, guys. So, there's your answer. So we can go ahead and create different baits. I don't know why would you do boars and coyotes, but that's up to you guys, of course. I'm sure there's going to be some sort of need for that. And then you've got alligators, which we haven't tapped into yet. So it doesn't look like that's going to be a thing, or we could make it. I don't know, actually. We'll definitely have a look. As you can see, pumas are now available. Alpha wolves. So really now it sort of depends on what animal that you want to commit to. So if I want to go say an alpha wolf or a puma, because you know we can go to panther mode, right? Bears, same situation. But yeah, look, I mean alpha wolf might be, oh, you know what, for me, what does the puma provide? Okay, so pet attack on enemies at full health grant 150% of damage. So that's only if you're not provoking any enemies. So that's a bit of a trade-off with that one there. With the bears, it's just improved provoking, so I don't know what that does. But these are rares, so this is probably locked behind a paywall, so you're not going to be able to do that or utilize them. Plains coyote. Pet dodges enemy attack with chance. So, I don't know. I reckon for now, I think I'm going to do the lynx only because the sharp claws attribute. Because even with this, it only stops your enemies or slows them down. Yeah, so they're really not going to do too much. And then you got the red wolf. And it's slow. Yeah, 15% slows them down by 20%. This is a physical stop. Only for a second, though. And then, as we said here, gives you 150% damage, provoking. And then you've got the mountain coyote, which dodges enemy attacks. Wild bear, just thrift. I don't know what that means. And then you've got the mature alligator, does double damage with 5% chance. So that might be the only other tangible one that you might want to consider. But for me, I think the lynx is probably going to be the way to go. But I think now, let's just jump out of here. Can't really talk to these guys anymore, but We can give the animal and my... Okay, so this changed. Right. So it looks like it sort of pays to max out your pets, because this was 12? Or no, it was still 20 in the previous video. My mistake. Still 20. So, yeah, I still think tier 1 is good for maximum... what do you call it? Maxing out your research. So it doesn't look like this place is going to disappear, which is good. Which is really good. Yeah, it's still there. So once we get back to the ranch, yeah, there you go. It's still accessible. So that makes sense, because obviously you've got the trader there now, as you can see. But also, this would also work for future updates as well, for pets that are in the pipeline. I've tried to actually ask the developers to see what's in the pipeline, and they're tight-lipped. I can't get any answers from them, unfortunately, but it is what it is. So, yeah, so there's no room for upgrading this station. It's just basically an informational guide for you. I don't think it's accessible here, so you actually have to... function the workstation itself. Let's go ahead and see if the bait station has changed. It has. Okay, there you go. There we are. There we have it. So you've got bears, you've got coyotes, and you've got the alpha wolf bait if you want to go down that pathway. And these are the different baits that you would need to craft up. Now turkeys, I'm going to need turkeys to continue the lynx side of things. This is going to take a while, so I don't know whether or not should I just bail on these and just focus on T1, which I'm thinking I'm probably going to be doing in this situation, only because that, yeah, it's not going to benefit me for waiting for 2 days just so I can get progression. So yeah, I think that's probably going to be the way to go. This one's on the cook, so I'm just going to let that one go and run its course. So I'm going to get rid of those, and I'm just going to craft up these sellers. Yep, so I think that's probably going to be the right move. And for everything else, if you really wanted to do other things as well, I don't know, I think the puma might be a good option as well, further down the line. So these are all, so you can lure coyotes if you really wanted to, but there's really no progression with this. Bears up to 25, 20 for the puma, alpha wolf 20, wolf 15, and then the boars is the standard, right? So at least you guys know how this all sort of works, and it obviously works based on how much you've invested in the pet lineage that you've actually assigned yourself to. So for me, lynx, I've only got the lynx 2 bait because I've committed to that line. Whereas for you guys, if you want to commit to something else now that you've completed the pet's quest, then you can offshoot and start something else if you really want to. But I'm going to stick with the lynx. But I think that's going to go ahead and do it today, guys. We've concluded the pet's update in its entirety for now. Now, there's going to be more later on. Obviously, we're going to be wanting to upgrade our pet house and things like that. I've only got the one bowl, as you can see. But hopefully, further down the line, I'll be able to get some more and we can prosper from thereafter. But yeah, I want to thank you guys for sticking with me with this little adventure. You guys have been amazing with your support, your views, your comments, your likes, shares, everything that you guys have done. Thank you very much. I'm going to be obviously continuing with more Westland videos. They're obviously going to be different now going forward, but we'll see what else and what type of adventures we can get ourselves involved in. And hopefully you guys stick around for the ride, sorry. And yeah, continue to support me and the channel. But anyway, appreciate you guys stopping by, checking out the video. So bye for now, catch you on the next one, and enjoy.